Charles and I set for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup as we get a peek some of the stars in today's game. Well, will they be stars? Will you be a star? We'll find out. Let's play. Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And with a new rule, that decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he only gets to the 20. So the D-line's going to spread out. They come out with one back and three tight ends. They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up 2nd and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Looking to throw. Dancing to his left. Room here to run. Call it a gain of 5. And they'll be faced with a 3rd and inches.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
An early test for this defense. Here we go on 3rd and inches.
Here we go. 3-19.
They'll try to run for it. Here's Williams. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on 4th down, and they're going to go for it. They'll try and throw for it here. And he locates Walker. Complete. And he's going to have the 1st down yardage to the 35. Give him 7 on the play. And on 4th down, they're able to convert and move the sticks. So here we go, 1st and 10 now. Back to throw here. And he will find his man on the outside. Give him 9 there on the 1st down completion.
That was not a completion that results in a highlight video. But at the same time, if you have those kind of completions all game long, eventually one of them might turn into a highlight.
They're going to look to throw. On the slant, he gets it to Gronkowski. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. That goes for a gain of 31.
Coaches really don't care from what position they get this. But run after the catch ability, rack ability, is often the difference between winning and losing and changing.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Justin Houston in the drop and behind the line, and that's a loss of a yard. Back to throw. No, bottled up. Fumble. It's out. It's loose. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. And without a doubt, not the way they pictured that opening drive unfolding.
No, they were making progress. They weren't exactly in high gear, but they were making a few yards along the way. And now that they've coughed it up, you got to go back to the sidelines and regroup a little bit.
Now this offense ready to head back out there. Play clock winding down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Now a first carry for Derrick Henry. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
And that's the type of play that'll fire up a defense. Hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
He'll look to throw. Thrown across his body, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the all-time interception, and he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Well, partner, I do know this. If you're a defensive back, you have more chances to make a team now than ever because people are using five defensive backs, six defensive back packages. Not exclusively, but way more than before. That was a nickel package there, and what a pickoff.
Why is that? Why are they using that more?
Because more people are throwing the ball on earlier downs than ever before. This has become a passing league, and because of that, more defensive backs on the field on most plays.
And it's good to make it 7-0. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. And here now the offense heading back out there. Here on first down, escaping the pressure right, and he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and that'll make this a second down. Offense in a good spot here, second and two.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Ooh, I like it.
Unable to get it to Gronkowski that time. And it's third and short.
Even in today's NFL, when we think of the tight end position now as really a glorified wide receiver, we're still asking a lot of those guys. They have to block as well. And every now and then, they don't come down with the football.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Looking for his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. Now fourth down.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now, he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. Throwing left side, it's complete. It'll be a 20-yard gain on the play. And they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down.
Mission accomplished on that throw. Slant, pick up the first down. I like how he just put it on the receiver and didn't lead him on that one.
Happened quickly. Defense, not much they could do. Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon as it's London football to begin quarter number two. Put him out on the slide. 2. They're looking at a second and short yardage to start things out. Now with the play clock about to expire, we get a whistle and a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Just 2 yards to go here on second down for the offense. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Goes underneath for Henry. And he's going to get this inside the 30. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
They come out here in the eye. A first down carry for Henry. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. Red zone opportunity. They'll need to get the playoff quickly. Again, it's Henry. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. Only 3 there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
Now, that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork and handle it a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
Derrick Henry. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. Derrick Henry, 14 yards. And his guys are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And there you go. Nothing really too complex. Block, keep to your assignments. Let them run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football. Good blocking beats good tackling on that play. End result, touchdown.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he's going to be out of bounds on the return. Not a great return. They'll start back around the 17. Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
If they're out there, we'll see if they can pick those things back up. On the ground, this is Williams. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Yardage here back to the 14-yard line. He lost 2 there, and it's third down. And we've arrived at the 2-minute warning here in half number 1. Got an extra defensive back out there now on 3rd and 13. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. Now Austin. 12 yards on the return that time, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Now this offense ready to take over again. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Leonard Williams in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. That one goes for 24 yards. And now a first down following that long gain. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He dumps it off for Henry. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
That play was well covered. Just tried to check it down. Unfortunately, not able to find any yardage on that one.
They'll look to throw here. And this is going to be caught. No, they say it's incomplete. Ed McCaffrey, the intended target. And it's third down.
Oh, he caught it. Just couldn't get the feet down. Couldn't get that toe-tap sequence, right? I was ready to call tippy-toes if that one was completed.
And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. So a penalty that can frustrate a coach so much, a mental error, and it'll back him up 5 yards. So a costly penalty, and now a tougher third down situation. They'll look to throw again. Looking left side, and it's complete. They get 15, but they still needed a little bit more. Fourth down, and play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And Boswell's kick is good. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. A little bit of a lower trajectory there on the deep kick, and it worked.
Had to do it because he had to drive it out low because of the length of the kick. Able to do that, got it above the defense and over the post.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. And now back out comes the offense. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Throwing left side, it's complete. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. They're going to look to throw toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So the incomplete pass brings up second down. To throw. Polluting the pressure right. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And avoids the cut. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Throw now on first down. He's got a man that's caught left sideline. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So here they come, the road team now getting the football first to start this third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Chains are on their sides. It's first and goal from the six. And he stopped immediately there. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
And frankly, Brandon, we're talking about things I'm not sure we ever thought we'd talk about in the NFL, and a lot of that is the speed at the linebacker position. A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties. They moved them up to outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses, and now we're seeing it in the NFL, those same guys using their speed to make plays in the backfield, similar to that one.
He'll look, and he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Paul Krause. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. Checks this one down to Williams. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. That is incomplete. He was trying to fit it into Gronkowski there, and that'll bring up second down. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Second and 10, he'll look to throw again. He's going to loft this one deep left sideline. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
So here we go now, an extra defensive back in there on third and 10. They'll look to throw, and he's going to drop this off to Williams, complete. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. Well, the offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. They're going to try and throw. And they hit him as he throws, as this one's going to go straight down to the turf. Incomplete. And they're not able to convert on fourth down. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They're moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. They come out here in the eye. On second down, here's Henry. And once again, not much running room, if any at all. Back-to-back stops make it third and 10. So back-to-back plays here where he couldn't get anything on the ground. Now you face a third and 10 and assume you're going to try to pass it, right?
I would think so, because you've tried to run the ball, and really it didn't matter who got the ball in the play because there was no space to go. So then I think you step back, throw the ball to try and pick up the first down.
The play clock's running down. Back to throw here. Flush to his right. He can run for it, and he will. Give him 8 on the play, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
It's a 47-yard field goal try from here, but instead they're going to opt to go for it on fourth down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Looking left side, and it's complete. But he's brought down, but not before reaching the 8-yard line. 22 yards on the pickup there, and the decision to go for it pays off. They've got a first and goal. They'll try to run for it with Henry. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
So often you hear defensive coaches talk about we need all 11 on every play in order to be a good run-stopping unit. And sometimes it starts to sound a little cliche, but did you see the free safety on that play? Knifing through and running down the ball carrier. A huge, huge play. And when you have a free safety who can run like that, you've got to turn him loose.
Henry, the lone man in the backfield. And he'll get it up the middle. Only about a yard there as he takes it from the 9 to the 8.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here, not even a thought, is it?
Defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I didn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
Hard throw, incomplete. The Hall of Famer Ozzie Newsome, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up a fourth down. And Boswell's kick is good. And the lead stretches to six here. It's 13-7. So they get the three here, but you wonder whether that's going to be enough.
Yeah, I mean, you've now made it so they need a touchdown rather than a field goal to catch them. But you're right. If they'd gotten six out of that drive, this would be a much different game.
Gets fielded in the end zone. This offensive unit as they get set to take over here. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. Good job by their defense, though. They held them to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one, and it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He gets it into the hands of Gronkowski, complete. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
Defense thinking pass. They've got the nickel set out on third and six. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
And they're going to at least line up to go for it here on fourth down. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. He's going to loft one deep left side here. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the ball will go over on downs on the short side of the field. Now this offense ready to head back out there. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point.
The kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post. That's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that'll help him in contract time. You could have kicked that one through. Now here's a timeout coming on the defensive side of the ball. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. And the offense here just looking to stay in bounds, complete the short passes, and put this game on ice. They'll run it again with Henry. He's able to get six, a nice pickup down to the 21. And now whistles blow here. Play has stopped, and we're going to get a timeout. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. And the defense in desperate need of a stop. They have to get off the field and get the ball back to their offense if they want a chance. They'll try to run for the first with Henry. And he's going to have a first down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. Third and two is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
Fourth quarter, two-minute warning about to hit, and it looks like they're going to get one more play in. It'll
be interesting to see what they try and do on this play. Do they try and take a shot, or do they just try and get to the two-minute warning?
Henry, and stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the three. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. Play clock almost out. Chip Kelly's going to take a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They come out with one back and three tight ends. And they'll turn to a power game to try to get in. Only a yard that time, second and goal.
Just keep the ball on the ground. Do a little pounding. Chew up some clock. If they can get it in, that might be enough to get them home. And if not, the clock is definitely their friend.
They come out here in the eye. And they'll let the fullback try and take them home. Call it no gain that time, and now it's third and goal.
Partner, when it's a goal-to-go situation, if you're on the field on defense, you have to know that you may be called on to make a tackle at any time. Here, the cornerback does exactly that. Plays the run really well and makes a big play.
Stonewalled on second down. Now let's see what they can do on third and goal from the two. They'll drop the throw. Losing 6 yards there to bring up fourth. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. And Boswell's kick is good. And that will make this a 9-point lead. So barring something extraordinary, something crazy here in the closing stages, that field goal should just about put this one on ice.
Brandon, this will be a great win for them. The better team's going to win this game, no question about it.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. And here now the offense heading back out there. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, two-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again. But they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly. Then they'll take it from there.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Now a desperation. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And what a big-time play there. 42 yards. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Jason Verrett, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. Getting down to the end here, they have a two-score lead. Barely, but it's a two-score lead, so that probably makes you as a coach feel a lot more comfortable right now, doesn't it, Charles?
It does, but it doesn't mean now you go out and run option or some kind of wild double reverse or anything like that. But you do know that if anything does go haywire, you're still in control of this game.
I want a double reverse, don't you?
I'm just waiting for that day where we actually see something like that in this situation.
We'll see what happens here. Failed me this morning and missed our AM workout. We still made it through this thing together, didn't we?
Well, you always know I need extra workouts just to keep up with you.
Come on.
So it doesn't matter, but thanks for sharing a booth and thanks for being our quarterback.
Yeah, you're the quarterback. Always a pleasure, my friend. So that'll do it for Charles Davis, the rest of our crew. I'm Brandon Gauden. This has been a presentation of Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. So long, everybody. We are set, ready to rock for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup, and these guys on your screen, ready to rock as well. Some of the stars of today's game, and speaking of the game, let's get right to it. Justin Tucker set to boom this one away. And off we go in Madden Ultimate Team. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Play clock winding down. They come out here in the eye. On the ground, this is Derrick Henry. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
A 1-yard gain could look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going.
Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
He'll look to throw. And he will find his man on the end route. Complete. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
They'll need to get the playoff quickly. They go play action here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
Complete to Newsome. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes, and that was it. Now you can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
Now the offense lining up first and 10. Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to get this one out to his fullback. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 7 yards on the play, and that'll make it a second down.
I think the good offensive coordinators of the league now are looking at the fullback position and finding the right guys to hide in that spot and increase their passing game, as we just saw there. How about the run after catch? Racked him.
Well, yeah, whether it's a true fullback, a tight end, you put in the fullback spot, you know they're going to be tough to bring down if you can get him the football in the passing game. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. The play clock's running down. They keep it with Henry on first down. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Ooh. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Gotta give some credit. They're able to hop up in the air and bat that one away. And that's frustrating for an offensive lineman because the only recourse is when he goes in the air to try and give some type of a pop or a shove, hoping to bring his arms down.
And he can't hang on to it. Nearly picked. He's known for his hands defensively. But instead, it just brings up fourth down. And it appears they'll go for it here on fourth down. A big call on the game's opening drive. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. Marvin Harrison, 42 yards. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead. Well, that's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score it.
And I don't know if that was scripted, was it an audible, or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket. No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 yards with a new rule as he's taken down right at the 20-yard line.
Yeah.
The first carry now for Ricky Williams. And
Yeah, she went right in there. Up to the 22.
Marvin, you know I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different from the norm.
I saw that when I came in. Y'all were both knocked out. But, you know, she don't sleep still. So, you know, she doesn't stay still while she sleeps. So, she jumped on down. I saw that. Just went ahead and threw her back there. In this challenging world, there's a pathway to excellence where dedicated men from all she was tired, I guess. Can meet on the level. The destination is an ancient brotherhood, the Freemasons of Maryland. Here, you got a remote if you up now.
Not a tendency breaker at all. That's just trying to establish yourself as you move forward.
Yeah, I think the battery is running low.
Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense.
Yeah, we need to get some new ones.
As we step aside, trying to heat up a little bit in this first quarter.
Nah, we can't have you in here cold. She's gotten a little used to my temperature.
And they still need 8 yards for the first here on second down.
Yeah.
Again, it's Williams. And he'll get this one up to the 26. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about four more for a first. They're going to look to throw. And he's got his man on the out route. So in their own territory, but they only need a few inches, so they're going to opt to go for this thing. We'll see. Maybe a surprise pass or run. What will they do? We're about to find out. Fourth down. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and they're able to convert here on fourth and inches. Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. It's Mexico City football to begin quarter number two, and they've got it here with a first down. Up second down.
Whenever I see a drop like that, I have to kind of take a step back and check myself a little bit. So used to seeing those big guys make big time spectacular plays that when they drop one, I have to remind myself, we ask a lot out of these guys. Block and catch the football, not easily done in today's NFL.
Offense looking to avoid a third and long at second and 10. Play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch it out a little bit, and they may have to change accordingly.
Yards to go on third. Now back to throw. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. And he'll be out of bounds up near midfield at the 49. They got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Justin Houston in there to sack him for a loss of 6. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning.
And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. Now on fourth down, the 2014 NFL leader is a rookie in yards per punt. Tress Way on to kick it. Back deep is Tavon Austin. This is taken at the 10. A very good return there. Give him an even 20 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. And now out comes Houston. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And the play goes for 19 yards, gives them a new set of downs. So the offense has it, first and 10. Now a handoff to Henry. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Second down following the run. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Again to Henry. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Strike, they'll look to throw. Gonna throw right side here, complete. The completion there winds up a wash, and it'll bring up 4th down. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We're back to Houston after this timeout. Offense staying out there. They look prepared to go here on 4th and 10. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And this is incomplete. Boy, a real head scratcher there. And this defense will take over right at midfield. Now this offense ready to take over again. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up, but you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over, right? You're giving it, giving your defense a chance because you're punting the ball away, and they're set to go on the field as opposed to sudden change after a turnover. And wow, now we got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
Forced out to his left. On the slant, he gets it to Gronkowski. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. A gain of 39 that time.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, it was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the ball.
And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Go, 319, zebra.
In motion left goes Sanders. Back to throw here. This will be caught at about the 5. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a 3rd down. They slot Gronkowski out right.
Here we go.
Now with just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
Short run there, and I think the easy thing is to look at them right now and say, let's get away from them entirely. Let's start throwing the football. But I don't think you ever entirely abandon the run. It helps set a tone for the game for you, keeps your offensive linemen feeling good about themselves, and it actually tamps down a defense's pressure, because if you just throw it all the time, it's going to tee off with the pass rush.
Halfback sent in motion. Now a whistle, and I think a penalty here for a delay. No, they're going to say timeout. They did get the timeout in time. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. And Tucker, the former Longhorn, puts this one through. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So a field goal here. They're still down, but they put a dent into that lead before the break.
And that's got to feel good, because now they've seen that they can put some more points on the board, and that gives them a whole second half to get back to where they want to be, and that's in the lead.
And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. And now out comes Houston. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Clapper! Clapper!
They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. First half in the books.
Jeez, I don't even want to let their guys get a drink of water.
All right, third quarter, let's get to it. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. That's fielded in the end zone. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 10 at the 9-yard line.
So many times during the course of a game, Brandon, the special teams actually helps out their offense. Not in this case. They did them zero favors with that return.
Very tough spot here for the offense to start. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. They'll set up the screen. This is Williams. 7 yards there on the first down screen play. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And Gronkowski's got it. Complete over the middle. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45.
Now that play will end up on the highlights, and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that got the extra time that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play possible. Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Six yards to go here on second down. They slot Gronkowski out right. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. Offense faces a third and medium with 6 yards left. They'll look to throw. And that is incomplete.
Well, sometimes you just have to take things into your own hands, don't you? I mean, the offense is really struggling in this game. They're the ones keeping things going. They have to continue to play at that level.
So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears trying to go for it on fourth. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And this is caught. He hits Landry. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there. All that practice time came to fruition on that play. All those timing routes that they work on through training camp, OTAs, mini camp, and just regular season, they got it done on that one. An outcut, ball was delivered, and picked up the completion.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he's going to go down. He sacked back at the 24. Jurrell Casey able to get him for a loss of about three. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. On third down, he'll drop to throw. And this is going to be incomplete. Landry, the intended target, and it's fourth down. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. He connected on his first, this from 41. And Tucker, the former Longhorn, puts this one through, and they'll get it back within a point at 7-6. So in the end, they had the ball for 10 plays, but the drive only yields 3 points.
Yeah, they were able to move the football, but the defense stiffened once their backs were to the end zone, and they were able to hold them to just 3.
Tucker now following the made field goal, set to kick it away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. Clock showing 90 seconds to go in the third. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And a first hookup with his veteran tight end, Dallas Clark. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
But we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, 2nd and 2, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. A lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yards runs, and goes to one of those.
And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. And now back out comes the offense. And a methodical drive last time, but they couldn't get that knockout blow. They had to settle for 3.
But you got to like what they've been doing along the way, right? It's almost like the body blows, the setup punch. As you said, they didn't get the knockout blow here, but that doesn't mean it can't come later in the game on another possession. And the defense on the other side,
maybe a little gas,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, a little tired. And if nothing else, they just feel relieved getting upfield and giving up 3. They don't exactly feel like they've handled the offense.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. He's got time in the pocket. Flushed out right. And he'll go down at the 28. Give him 2 yards on that play. And that'll bring up 2nd down. And they're going to speed things up here.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on 1st and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
He'll look to throw. He's got time, and he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. Give him 6 on the play, and all of a sudden here, it's 3rd down. They'll go to the air here on 3rd and 2. Looking for Gronkowski, and he's got him complete. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And he's just going to throw this one out of bounds here. Nowhere to go with it. Incomplete.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. Fake. They'll look to throw. And he can't hang on. That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone. Defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this down only to the 18. 2 yards on the pickup there. It's fourth down. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This for a fourth quarter lead. And Tucker, the former Longhorn, puts this one through. And they jump back in front here. It's 9-7. So the drive here ends with a field goal, and that does give them the lead, but this one is still a long ways from over.
And you love to be able to look up at the scoreboard and see that you're out in front, but then you take one look across the field and see that offense is raring to come back out, and you think, I don't know, the field goals are going to be enough to get us home.
Tucker now following the made field goal, set to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And his guys are going to start their drive right at the 20-yard line. And now out comes Houston. And let's see what the defensive coordinator may have up his sleeve here to try to get this final last stand and win this football game. He'll look to throw. Over the middle, that's complete to McCaffrey. That one goes for 24 yards.
He had time, was able to survey the field, and find a soft spot in that zone coverage.
And that's where it gets difficult for a defender, Brandon. You go to your spots on the field that you have to cover, and when the offense finds an area that you're not in, that's where they throw the football.
So this offense really needs to make something happen here late in the fourth with the football. On first down, he'll drop the throw toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups, and they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. To the sideline and complete to Gronkowski. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. So here we go. The offense is going to stay out there. They're going for it on fourth and eight. And they're going to go soft on the corners. Time running out here on the play clock. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Deion Sanders, the Hall of Famer, with a pick. This one home. It's a touchdown. So they go on fourth down. Not only do they not get it, it turns into 6 points the other way. Disastrous.
And many people think you should just go ahead and knock it down in that situation. Turn it over for the offense. But I had a defensive coordinator recently tell me, we see that as a passive play. We don't do that anymore. We want the ball in our hands, and we want to head the other way.
Probably also instinct a lot of times. If you see a lot of green grass ahead of you, go ahead and grab it.
It's the exact right play to do. That's knowing when to break the rules and when to make a play that maybe you hadn't been taught.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now out comes Houston. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Escaping the pressure right. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
Goes underneath for Henry. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. Call it a pickup of 7, and that'll make it second down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And this complete to Henry over the middle. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. And some changes here as the D-line separates some.
Not only did we just see back-to-back nice gains, but we're also seeing the confidence rise, not just for the guy who caught it, but the guy throwing it as well.
And these back-to-back catches here out of the backfield, that can set something up downfield in a later sequence, right?
A lot of the time, it starts to draw the defense closer to the line of scrimmage. So to your point, show this swing pass, show this check down. Maybe later on, you heave one deep when you catch them close to the spot.
Obviously a tough spot here. They need a lot of luck to win this game, but still a small chance.
They've got to make sure they get the ball to the sidelines, get out of bounds, preserve clock.
Back to throw now on second and 10. Oh, nearly picked. And maybe lucky there. This guy doesn't drop many defensively. Third down.
Not only did they drop what looked like an interception in the end zone, they blew a golden opportunity to shift the momentum.
They're going to look to throw. Bryant with a catch right side. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up fourth.
Timing is everything, and they work on this cut all the time. They work on all the timing patterns, and this time it paid off for them. worked into the center of the field, cut it to the outside, ball's delivered, gets both feet down for the completion.
And Boswell's kick is good. And the deficit trimmed to six now at 16-10. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point, but no problems converting there.
On to the kicking team, get it? Yes! The onside kick works like a charm. So they've accomplished half the mission, Charles. They get the onside kick. They do need a touchdown here, but they've got some time to do it.
In the excitement, there's no need to press. Plenty of time. They have the opportunity. Now they just need to execute and finalize things.
So the D-line's going to spread out, and he goes in motion here in the backfield. Back to throw. Steps away to his left. He's going to let it. That's caught at the 25. A gain of 32 that time. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Fresh set of downs here. Back to throw, eluding the pressure right. His throw caught right around the six. 18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal.
Sometimes it's design, but sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And on that play, he's able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Henry, the lone man in the backfield. And they'll get it up the middle. And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage.
Oftentimes, when you're not winning at the point of attack for an offensive line, maybe they're getting out physical. Spread things out a little bit, make it more of a one-on-one blocking scheme. Then you don't have to win it physically. You just have to win it by position. That may open things up for your running backs.
Back to throw. And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it in the end zone. A big time drop.
He'll look to throw, and that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go. That's a tough one not to hang on to on third and goal, but good job defensively to get there and jar it loose.
Agreed. That was really, really nicely done because there's no pass interference on the play. Timing excellent to get in there and knock it away. A win for the defense, and it brings up fourth down.
One final shot. They'll look to throw, and that is incomplete. 2 seconds left on the clock, and they're going to come up empty here on fourth down. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. Only one timeout defensively, so this should just be a simple kneel down.
I agree totally. I looked at my time management chart. It says take a knee, victory formation. They just have one timeout left, and that should be all she wrote.
By the way, it's a good thing you can read that because nobody else can.
Not with my chicken scratch, not at all.
That one looks like he'll throw here. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And it's incomplete. They're still throwing to the very end. But now this game is over. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you primed the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. This has been Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Join the discussion on Twitter at @EA_MUT. So long, everybody.
tonight, we ain't going out. So we invited everybody. The drink we made, well, they're way too strong. But ain't nobody saying sorry. The speaker.
Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis, ready for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup as you get a peek at some of the big players in today's game, and you're a big player in today's game as well. Let's get the party started. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. For the first time with Ricky Williams. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and two. On second down, Williams. And he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32. Tom Mahali there to bring him down. Oh, it's a nickel set here defensively on third and inches.
Still got to be prepared for a pass.
He'll look to throw. And he finds McDonald. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains.
He went full scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key first down.
Yeah, really nice job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab. On the left side, it's McDonald.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
And that's the kind of pass that adds up over time, Brandon. You may not have picked up a first down there, but if you keep chipping away at it, eventually big plays may result.
So this brings up a second and two. They'll run it with Williams. And no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47. Williams. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively. And it likely forces a punt situation on fourth.
That was a terrific job by the defense stopping them on third and short. But sometimes you get some visual cues from the offense, because when they're going in short yard situations, you might see the offensive line come in tighter together, a little more shoulder to shoulder, trying to wedge a hole in the middle. They didn't get it done on that play.
And in their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're going to line up to go for this thing on fourth down. They're going to try and throw. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. So they give it up just on their side of midfield. And, yeah, I mean, a surprising decision there to go for that.
Must have a lot of confidence in his defense. Must feel like, hey, we're in great shape here because our defense can hold them, because they're really outside of field goal range now, all right, the opposite team. So if you hold them here, you haven't given up any points. You may give up a punt and you're pinned down a little bit, but must have thought it was an okay spot to go for it and decided to be aggressive.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown. Derrick Henry, 39 yards. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead. And they're in on the first play from scrimmage. Our crew and you and I, we better strap in here.
That's what's commonly known as quick strike. Points on the board. This can be a fun game.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. That's fielded in the end zone. And last year, that would have been a net gain of 5 on the return. This year, he stopped where he would have been if he had taken a knee, and that's at the 25. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. Left side here to Sanders. That throw good for 4. It's second down. Williams, and he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a 3rd down and 6. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just boom, quick, 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 and what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
He'll drop to throw. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs. Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to float this one deep right side. A battle for it, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Now this offense ready to head back out there. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence.
And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. But fortunately, another offensive player quick to react, and they will indeed retain possession. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. You probably talked about this training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. There's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away. Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon as it's London football to begin quarter number two. They've got a second and nine to start things out. Nine yards still remaining here to pick up the first on second down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he will take it in for the touchdown. Tavon Austin, 76 yards. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. Well, he's used to running it that distance. Here he had to catch it, too, before making the run. Heck of a play for the score.
There's not many things better for an offense than a back who is a complete guy who can run it and catch it. And we just saw him complete a big-time play for a touchdown.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. And here now the offense heading back out there. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Try to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And he's got his man, the tight end, McDonald. And he gets this one just shy of the 40 to mark him down at the 39.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
He's going to let this one go deep. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Second down now after the incompletion. Here's Williams, and he's swallowed up right near the line of scrimmage. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
When people see Vince Wilfork, they don't think about his versatility, do they? But we've seen that throughout his career where he's actually played some defensive end as well as his expected defensive tackle and nose tackle positions. Strength, great, great quickness inside. That allows him to make plays in the offensive backfield.
Absolutely a run stopper.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done. 9 yards. 15, 17,
They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. Looking for the out route. It's completed to Landry. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Throwing left side, it's complete. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now's a play caller. Because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And his throw here is incomplete. Here comes the eighth play of the drive, and they need a full 10 yards on third down. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. On third down, he'll drop to throw. Looking for someone, and he'll go down. Brought down at the 20-yard line. Two minutes to play here in the first half. Back to the booth right after this. And Tucker's kick right there. It's good. And they will get themselves on the board here at 14-3. So three drives now for this offense, and that field goal gives them their first 3 points.
Yeah, as an offensive coordinator, if you're averaging a point a drive, you're in the wrong line of work. But in his defense, this has been a stifling defense so far. So they've got to start finding a way to unlock them as this game goes on.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. Now it's Henry. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
On offense, the guy that you want to have the best eyes on the field are your quarterback, so you can see everything pre-snap, and then, of course, as the play develops. On defense, oftentimes it's the linebacker, and on this play, his eyes took him right to the ball, and he made a nice tackle.
He's going to get this one out to his fullback. It's a gain of 7, and that'll bring up a third down. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So here we go, a third down after the second down pass completion. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he goes out of bounds across the 40-yard line. It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh set of downs.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Again, he'll drop to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, go to a zone blitz game.
And that is intercepted. Or was it? Wait, they'll say no. No interception. He did not keep the feet in bounds, apparently. So that's just going to be an incompletion. connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Flush to his right. The catch made by DeAndre Hopkins.
That's more.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
Go, mommy. Go, mommy.
So here we go, first and ten now. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. They'll set up a throw. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had to fly, just sending the guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And that will be incomplete with the clock showing 18 seconds now to go. Been a pretty long drive. This will be play number 9, and they need 10 yards out of it on third. Play clock all the way to 0. Didn't get the snap off. 5-yard penalty.
And you see the head coach writing that note on his play sheet right now. He's going to be addressing that with his staff. A sense of urgency. Get to the line of scrimmage. Snap the ball.
Put two receivers left, two to the right. After the penalty, it's Henry. And he'll get it down to the play to the 37. Call it a gain of 5. Fourth down now. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Kick is absolutely perfect, and they will stretch the lead now to 17-3. And that field goal caps an 11-play drive.
That's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points, but they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will be fielded at the 8. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Now this offense ready to take over again. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And he will find his man on the outside. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. And how about this right out of the locker room? An onside kick attempt. And the hands team does its job. They're able to secure it. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators, they sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach, we can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
Second half begins with a run by Henry. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Defense in a good spot. Let's see how the offense responds with a second and 13 now. Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete. The Pro Bowler DeAndre Hopkins, the intended receiver. And it's third down. Here, the defense in a dime look. They'll drop to throw, and he fires one, but incomplete. Here's Johnny Hacker now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. Score that a 36-yard punt. And possession will switch here as this offense will come on deep in their own territory. They slot Gronkowski outright. They'll come out throwing here on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Tiger! Here we go. Up in the ice. Up in the ice. That's it.
And second and 10. He'll look to throw again. Right side. That's complete to Gronkowski. He's at the 30. 10. Touchdown! Rob Gronkowski, 87 yards. And his guys have made this a one-score game now. When they drew that up, I don't think they envisioned it ending in a house call, but he got it and took it all the way home.
Really impressive run after the catch, wasn't it? That was really special by him. But let's face it, in today's NFL, those tight ends are often former wide receivers, or maybe even sometimes bigger running backs. They just put them in a position to get a great matchup and make plays like that.
This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20. Call it the 21-yard line. And now back out comes the offense. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage. Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. It's a gain of 9 yards, and it'll be second and about a yard.
It's interesting because
I think the whole series is like, last like three episodes, everybody's moving to Mexico. Now,
my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks. But it doesn't matter what you call
Linda down there.
It's who you
gotta move,
there.
Move down there with her.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
Yeah, should be on an end ball.
This is Henry. And the hole closes quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. And third quarter here, you've got the lead. This is where that strong run game can really benefit you. Stayed in bounds there, kept the clock going.
I like all the points you just made there. And if you throw the football and it's incomplete, now you've stopped the clock and you've helped out the guys on the other side of the ball. So keep it in the hands of those runners. Keep moving and keep grinding clock.
Call it a gain of 5 there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up.
Looks like a nickel set here defensively on third and two.
Maybe expecting a throw. He'll look to throw.
Oh,
throw but incomplete. The intended receiver, Tavon Austin, and it brings up fourth down.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. Play clock winding down. Looking to throw. And he finds a man. It's McCaffrey. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40.
We always hear about guys wanting to make plays that quiet a crowd. Yeah. After that one.
Here in the third quarter, they were hoping to get the stop, get the football back. Not the case.
What a completion on a fourth down play.
They come out here in the eye. A first down carry for Henry. And some room to roam now. And he'll get down to about the 26-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
Not ideal spot to be on first down, but I love that the play caller did not immediately abandon the running game and say, okay, we got to throw in order to pick it up. Stayed with the run, was rewarded with a big-time pickup. Now they're in second and manageable.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. They'll try and run with their fullback. Only a gain of a yard there, but it indeed gets them a new set of downs.
I don't know about you, partner, but on second and inches, a lot of the times I'm leery about the offensive guys thinking about taking a shot downtown. Instead, they just hand it to the big man and let him rumble forward for a first down.
Welcome back live to Orlando as we're about ready to rock and roll for the fourth and final quarter. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They go play action here on first down. Allen's got it over the middle. And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. No gain on the play there. It'll be second down. The defense loves to hang their hat on that, don't they? You get a guy that catches the ball, but you stop him for no gain.
Without a doubt, because they're also used to trying to catch people after the catch, and they miss. And that turns into what? A huge play. We've seen it so many times. In this case, though, catch was made, put down right on the spot.
A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
There's no doubt that his size is a factor, but I've seen a lot of big running backs in the league not have that kind of impact because they don't run like a big back should. Get behind their pads, as they like to say, lower center of gravity, and knock people backwards. Sometimes they run too upright and take too many hits. Not this guy. He knows how to get low, break tackles,
hey,
and gain additional yardage.
Hey, Smoothie. Hey, little Smoothie.
And the offense readies for play number 10 of this series.
I love you, man.
Again, it's Henry. And he'll take this one down near the 15. Now, defensively here, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter.
Out of their packaging, let's take a closer look at Minnie Mouse. She is beautiful. She's got a pink dispenser and a matching pink bow. Which looks
Bam.
Hey guys, it's Sparkle Spice, and today I'm super excited.
And the seemingly endless drive continues.
Yes.
Dispensers. They look like so much fun, and they're so colorful, so I can't wait to get these guys open and see how
they work. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Now a stoppage here. We'll get another timeout. That's going to leave him with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. So they're leading. They have possession of the football, and certainly this is where they just want to milk the clock. And they'll add a DB in the secondary here on third and 14. They'll run it now out of the gun. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That will be their third and final stoppage as they'll only have the 2-minute warning now remaining.
Except for Daisy, who comes with a raspberry.
And Boswell's kick is good. And they double. here. That makes our score 20-10. So his second field goal of the game, and that could turn out to be the big one.
Yeah, you have to make them score twice to beat you, and that's not impossible. But here in the fourth quarter, puts their backs clearly against the wall.
Come on, thank you.
So here comes the offense back onto the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. Looks like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did know, they are down on the scoreboard.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. He's going to float this one deep right side. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down. 10 yards still left on second down. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Looking for his running back, and he's got it. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
Oh, that's something, huh?
All we want about football being a game of strength and brawn, it's also a game of mismatches. And they're trying to create one there. Getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker, maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
Hey guys, it's Sparkle Spice, and I am super excited because I get to open some Disney Pets dispensers.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. 26 yards on the pick up there, and that'll give him a first down. Is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. And it looks like this will be the last play before the 2-minute warning. Stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this.
Are you sleeping, Mom? Huh?
Uh-huh.
You're asleep. He just went to sleep.
And that is no good. And this score will stay right where it is.
He's just got a long trip.
Well, this winds up in empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
See if the defense wants to stop it as they take the lead.
I'm super excited because I get to open some Disney Pez dispensers. They look like so much fun. and they're so colorful, so I can't wait to get these guys open and see how they work. Let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so first up, we have Mary.